Namaste everyone, and welcome to SVAR, the voice of jewelers, where we will discuss the ongoings in the fashion, gems and jewelry industry. I am SVARA, the world's first AI anchor of the fashion, gems and jewelry industry by SVAR Media Network. I am here to share with you the current updates about the industry. The latest news in India. Gold prices in India crossed the mark of 65,000 rupees per 10 grams in the first week of December 2023. IIJ's signature 2024, facilitating over 1,300 exhibitors at dual venues in Mumbai at Geo World Convention Center and Bombay Exhibition Center. Surat Diamond Bourse won the Best Office Building Award at the World Architecture Festival in Singapore. Spanning 6.7 million square feet, designed by Morphogenesis. Reena Ahluwalia's Royal Mysore paintings, acquired by C. Krishna Chetty Crystal Museum, showcase the opulence of the past and the historical legacy of Indian gems and jewelry. Today, we have a very special guest with us, Reena Ahluwalia. She is a diamond lover. She is an award-winning Canadian jewelry designer, painter, professor, and digital artist. Reena's work evoke precision, fluidity, and movement. Hi Reena, congratulations on your paintings acquisition by the C. Krishna Chetty Crystal Museum. How do you feel about it?
Thank you, Swara. I feel museum is a perfect place for these paintings. You know, I wanted to paint and record the historically accurate gems and jewels of India on canvas. And I'm truly grateful to C. Krishna Chetty Crystal Museum and Dr. Vinod Hayekar, who's such a legend and visionary in our gems and jewelry industry, to preserve these artworks for future generations.
The Royal Mysore paintings stand out from anything we've seen. Your paintings are so detailed, every inch adorned with gemstones and diamonds. Can you share a bit more about them?
Oh yes, for sure. The Maharaja and Maharani of Mysore's bodies are Golconda diamond clad, and they're wearing historically accurate gems and jewels from the southern Indian kingdoms. The backdrop of the paintings, if you see, are these colossal Burmese ruby and a giant Colombian emerald, reminding us of the grandeur of the Darbar Hall of Palace of Mysore. But besides the royal portraiture and the historic record, I hope when you look at my paintings, they are a reminder that we too are the Maharajas and the Maharanis of our lives. We are as resilient and luminous as diamonds and gemstones.
Thank you so much, Reena. It was good to have you with us and for such a delightful insight. Aditya Birla Group-backed Giva achieved an operating revenue of 165 crore rupees in FY23, marking a 97% increase from the previous fiscal year. However, the startup reported a net loss of 45.2 crore rupees, a 138% rise from FY22. Sabyasachi High Jewelry raises awareness about endangered Indian elephants in Assam through the Assam Bracelet. Bhima Jewelers aims to open 10 to 12 stores annually starting in 2024, focusing on expanding in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Melora inaugurated its new store in New Delhi. The brand aims to open more than 400 stores in the next 5 years to achieve $1 billion in sales. Senco Gold expects strong sales during the winter wedding season, forecasting a blended growth of 25%. Enticed by KGK plans to open 10 more stores in India by March 2025, blending aestheticism, elegance, and style with international designers and craftsmen for exclusivity. Tanishq has reopened its largest store on VIP Road in Vishakhapatnam, spanning 12,000 square feet. Kalyan Jewellers expands with Bollywood stars Janvi Kapoor and Aditya Roy Kapoor, inaugurating showrooms in Kashipur and Kolkata. The inaugural sovereign gold bond tranche is maturing, yielding early investors a 12.9% annual net return with a 2.75% fixed interest. Platinum Evara's Becoming Me campaign by PGI India highlights the personal journeys of Indian cricketer Jemima Rodrigues and playback singer Nithyashree Venkataraman. Moving forward to the international gems and jewelry platform, Tanishq moves to cater to the growing Indian diaspora in the US and expands its presence in Texas with new stores in Houston and Frisco. Chow Ta Fook, a leading Chinese jewelry retailer, reports a 6.4% year-on-year revenue increase to 49.5 billion Hong Kong dollars in H1 2023, driven by improved retail activity. Core operating profit rises 37.7%. De Beers Group has announced the departure of David Prager, Executive Vice President and Chief Brand Officer, and Ryan Parry, Acting Executive Vice President of Strategy and Innovation, in 2024. Now, De Beers Group has appointed Tom Johnson as General Counsel, effective 1st January 2024. Malabar Gold and Diamonds opens its 335th global store, marking its debut in Canada. It is the largest jewelry store in Canada and offers over 30,000 designs. Entering the exciting news from the fashion world, Reliance Retail has inaugurated the 10th store of its premium fashion and lifestyle brand, Azote, spread across 21,000 square feet in Ahmedabad. Jimmy Choo celebrated the opening of its Mumbai store at Jio World Plaza with a star-studded cocktail party. Bugatti Shoes expands in India with its first West India store in Pune's Phoenix Mall. Keeping up with the international news, a record 200.4 million US consumers shopped over Thanksgiving weekend, with 121.4 million visiting physical stores and 134.2 million shopping online. Richmond's digital strategy faces challenges as Farfetch's financial troubles make the YNAP deal unattractive. Lalit Group has secured a licensing deal to create and distribute fragrances for Japanese jeweler Mikimoto, with the first crystal edition launching in 2025 and a global luxury perfume line in spring 2026. Gucci faces workers' strike as artisans protest the proposed relocation of design employees from Rome to Milan, viewing it as a disguised mass layoff. While Gucci claims no staff reduction, uncertainties remain, and some see it as a trendier approach amid recent leadership changes. Morgan Stanley downgrades LVMH for the first time in 6 years, citing concerns about weakening demand in the luxury sector due to higher interest rates and inflation. That was all for today. Thank you, everyone. We will see each other next week with more weekly updates. I am Swara, world's first AI anchor of the fashion, gems and jewelry industry by SVAR Media Network, signing off. Until then, स्वस्थ रहिए, मस्त रहिए, शुभ रात्रि, शुभ शबाखैर.